Shout out to the supporters of Tupac Was Lyrical. And that's to my homegirl Ivy from Nigeria. My man Derm DZL1. My man Machiavelli. Can't forget my man Rich Nice. Can't forget my man Drix B. Definitely can't forget Slim 400. Can't forget my man Gangland. Can't forget Lopez Navarro. Definitely can't forget Slip and Roll Boxing. Always chiming in, always checking in. I definitely feel you. Definitely can't forget Heaven Sent. Can't forget Charles Carter. Right now, we about to get into Tupac's Papa song. Fuck you. Had to play catch by myself. What a sorry sight. A pitiful plight. So I pray for a starry night. Please send me a pop before puberty. The things I went through to see a piece of family unity. Mom's always work. I barely see her. I'm starting to get worried without her pops. I grow to be her. It's a wonder they don't understand kids today. So when I pray, I pray I never grow to be that way. And I hope that he answers me. I heard God don't like ugly, but take a look at my family. A different father every weekend. Before we get to meet him, they break up before the weekends. I'm getting sick of all the friendships. As soon as we kick it, eat and split in the whole shit. Ends quick. How can I be a man if there's no role model? Striving to save my soul, I stay cold. Chicken and a 40 bottle. So sorry. Let's just jump right into the second verse. Man, child in the promised land could have bought many heroes. Mars was the only one there, my pops was a no-show. And oh, I guess you didn't know that I would grow to be so strong. Looking kind of pale, was it the ale or pops was wrong? Where was the money that you said you would send me? Talked on the phone and you sounded so friendly. Ask about school and my welfare. But it's clear you ain't sincere, hey, who the hell cares? You think I'm blind, but beside my see you coming, Jack. You cried to go, left the broke, now ain't no one in back. Ask about my mom's like you love. Papa song. This is why I relate to Tupac. Tupac got a song called Papa Song. Tupac got a song called Mama's Just a Little Girl, Dear Mama. Tupac just got songs where that's just relatable to your life, bro. You know what I'm saying? And this one in particular definitely hits home for me. You know what I mean? My mom's got pregnant with me when she was 14 and my sperm donor. I don't call him Papa, I don't call him Daddy, I don't call him Father. And my sperm donor was of age in his 20s. So my mom's been, and my mother had me, she got pregnant with me, she was 14, she had me when she was 15. And she got kicked out of the house by her parents. I don't even want to get into that. But I have reasons to despise that dude. He should still man up to his responsibilities. Instead of letting the person like me grow it up without a father, that's just not cool. You know what I mean? Psychologically, it messes with you. It does something to you for the rest of your life, regardless of how strong people may perceive you to be, regardless of how, you know, happy or whatever the people may perceive you to be. But if you don't really know what I'm going through, knowing the struggles and knowing how it is to have an absentee male role model in the house, then you just can't assume that I'm great. So that leads me to, that's my segue into talking about 50 Cent and his son. What I see 50 Cent and his son going through, like, it really bothers me. It really bothers me. You know what I mean? Seeing that. Because regardless, men, we have an innate responsibility to take care of our child or our children by that woman, even if we're going through a certain kind of chaotic crisis with the mother of the children. We still got to do what we, especially black men, we still got to do what we need to do in order to raise our children in the white man's world. You know, shout out to Tupac's song, White Man's World. And so I say that to say is that 50 Cent will go publicly and put a lot of blame on his baby moms. Now, let's break this down real quick. You know, 50 Cent, if the movie Get Rich or Die Trying is right, because I don't know this man personally, but if the movie Get Rich or Die Trying is right, that you displayed that the mother of your child was there when you got shot up. She was there to nurture, there to care for you, gave you advice, suggestions, held you down. So when you get on and become this big star, this big mega star, and then you start seeing all these kind of beautiful women that you probably didn't really encounter. People like Megan Good, people like Vivica Fox, even white women like Chelsea Handler. You know, it's no telling who 50 Cent rocked with. So when your attention begins to go elsewhere, and now you're on the road, you're constantly got to do shows, do videos, you got to do, you know, movies, and you signing autographs, and you're meeting so many people. Now, how do you feel your baby mom's is going to feel? And then once you finally break it off with her, you get rich and you stop trying to make it work with the child of your mother. Now, they probably had their little discrepancies. They probably had their little problems that's going on. I don't know them personally. I'm from the outside looking in. And what I seen was just like, all right, so 50 began to pay more attention to industry women or groupies and stuff like that. So put yourself in his baby mom's shoes. You know, how you think she's looking at that shit? Like, damn, nigga, I was there for you when you got shot. I was there for you, you know, to nurture this son right here. She even admitted that she was going to have an abortion, and 50 Cent gave her the money to get an abortion. But then 50 Cent said, nah, he wanted to, you know, keep the child. He wanted her to keep the child. So boom, little Marquise is born. So whatever took place after that, once in the rap game and this stuff like that, I think 50's focus just went elsewhere, and he just got so deep into the industry, into fame, that, you know, he was really didn't have too much of a concern for a relationship with the child's mother. So boom, arguments started ensuing, things started taking place, house burning down. And, you know, 50 just said the hell with it. So we kind of like turned his back, not only on her, but you really turned your back on your son. So when you turn your, so when the father turns his back on their child or walks away from their child, now you got that child or the children in the household with a scorned mother. Who's going to berate the children's father? Who's going to say, yo, your daddy wasn't this, your daddy ain't that, your negative things, you know, probably nothing positive at all. And the children, more than likely, they might grow to believe everything that their moms are saying is true about their father, especially if the father isn't present. So now you got little Marquise saying $6,700 a month ain't cool, whatever, whatever. He's saying a lot of things. It might be ignorant things. It might be nonsensical things. It might be the right thing. It might be the wrong thing is what he's saying. But what he's, you know, he's saying these things because he didn't have no proper role model. He didn't have his father there after a while. Your father, you was in my life for, you was in, 50 Cent was in his father, 50 Cent was in his son's life for a time period and then bounced. And basically made it seem like it was due to the fact of his mother is the reason why he bounced and the reason that he's not there. So when you get wealthy like 50 Cent, like, see if you can get custody of your child or something like that. More than likely, I'm sure you could have got it. You know what I mean? You made way more money, and your son probably would have been better off being with his father instead of being with his mom's at that time. You know, let especially if she wanted to have an abortion at one point in time, and then you decided to pay for the abortion, then change your mind. Well, don't never keep that. Don't lose that frame of mind that, yo, you could have murdered your son, because that abortion is murder. You could have murdered your son 25 years ago, but you chose to be a father. But now we see 50 Cent and his son going at it. We see 50 Cent on the TV show Power, you know, on the first couple seasons, 50 Cent kills his son. That shit was heartbreaking. I was just like, yo, damn. I'm like, yo, he killed his son. Like, this is a 50 Cent show. Is this a metaphor to how you really feel personally about your son right now? And then, is this a metaphor to how you feel about your son right now? And then there was the other part where in the Power series where the son kills the father, which was Tyreek killed the father, which was Ghost. And I was just like, yo, this shit is crazy. But like, yo, the things that I'm not saying that shit don't happen, but as black men, we got to at least symbolize some type of greatness. Like, we shouldn't be out here showing showing us, showing a father murdering his son, or showing a son murdering their father. It should just, especially for those watching, especially for those who've been through that. I remember watching The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air and seeing when Will Smith's father was around, and then his father left, and then he was just like, Will did a great freaking job in that episode. Then he was just like, yo, how come my father don't want me, Uncle Phil? But he was like, it don't matter, because I'm going to be a better father than him. I'm going to be this, I'm going to be that, and I'm going to be damn sure be there for my kids. You know what I'm saying? And that's just how I felt. And this is why I felt like a failure in my life, because, you know, I had my daughter very young. I was 19 when I got my baby mom's pregnant, and I was 20 when my daughter was born. You know, I wasn't highly educated. I was in school and I dropped out of college. I took on these little bullcrap jobs for the rest of my life, all the way until this point. I never had no father figure. I never had no real, my uncles wasn't really there giving me no encouragement. Them dudes started smoking drugs and stuff like that. So I really never had nobody there to give me that proper guidance, man. So the best thing that I did in life was to be a better father for my daughter, but I skipped out on a lot of other things. You know what I mean? I should have educated myself more. I should have traveled more. I should have learned languages. There's so much more that I should have did that I didn't do, because the only thing I was trying to be was better than my sperm donor. So going back to this 50 Cent and his 50 Cent and his son Marquise, I don't blame his son. I don't blame the baby mother. I blame 50 Cent. The late, great Patrice O'Neal said, you know, if your woman begins to talk to you, begins to belittle you as a man and things of this nature, it's your fault for allowing that to happen. So I blame 50 Cent for letting his baby moms get to him to the point where he was like, I'm done. He's canceled her, and you walked away. No, all right, you done with her? All right, but don't be done with your child. Don't be done with your child. Now the whole world is, now so many people are ridiculing 50 Cent's son. And I just feel like that's really unnecessary. You know what I mean? Like, because 50 Cent needs to step up. It would be so great to see 50 and his son make amends. So then 50 has another child by another woman. Now check this out. 50 Cent has a baby by a lady named Daphne Joy. And she's from the Philippines, so she's a Filipino woman. Now, mind you, 50 Cent said a couple of years ago, he likes these exotic women. He likes women that look like they fresh off the boat. So he wasn't basically bigging up black women. A lot of black women took offense to that. You know what I'm saying? And then, so when the black men and the black women, especially particularly in America or of the African diaspora, when they're dealing with each other, when we look into each other, we see a mirror reflection of ourselves, because the black man is struggling in the white man's world, and so is the black woman struggling in the white man's world. But if you're in an interracial relationship, a black man dealing with a white woman, he ain't going to see the same struggles. He's going to see something totally different. Regardless, if a black man dealt with an Asian, if a black man deals with maybe even a Spanish, but definitely you dealing with a Filipino, that's just like Dave Chappelle. Dave Chappelle's wife is Filipino. It's not black women. Not saying there's nothing wrong with that. And I'm sure they got African in their DNA. But you're dealing with women who ain't going through the same struggle. So you might be dealing with women who are more submissive than a black woman would be. Because the black man and the black woman, we going through a certain kind of struggle. It's hard out here for us. And you've seen how hard it is, particularly in America, for the last 4 centuries or more. How hard it is for a black man and a black woman. And you know, and to break up, and how easy it is to break up the black family. So 50 is paying a lot of attention to his second born son. And, you know, learning from the mistakes that he made with his first baby moms. But it's just a shame, because now his younger, from my understanding, so his second oldest son probably doesn't even have a relationship with his older brother. So we ain't even thinking about that. So we just, the bitterness. So now, is Marquise going to keep growing up? Is this shit going to turn to anger? Is it going to turn to hate? Is he going to play out? Is he going to become a Tyreek and kill ghosts? So that's all I'm saying, man. So when you hear this song, like Papa's Song by Tupac and shit like that, it just made me reflect on that, man. It just made me reflect on that real quick, man. So There's probably some points that I'm missing, some things that I'm missing, but you know, I just had to get that out, you know, get that off my chest for a minute, bro. Like, I have reasons for despising my sperm donor. That brother ain't shit. I shouldn't even call him a brother. That man ain't shit. You know what I'm saying? And I just feel like, yo, publicly, I would love to see 50 and his son make amends. You know, if they can, you know, make that shit happen. But anyway, man, forgive me if, you know, if I got too far off the topic, but this Tupac song, Papa song, definitely made me think about Marquise and 50 Cent. Salute.